Hey everyone, Eric here. In this video, we're going to learn how to forecast a depreciation schedule in Excel using our CAPEX plan. Then I'll show you how to link depreciation back into the balance sheet as accumulated depreciation, the income statement as an expense, and the cash flow statement as an adjustment to net income in the operating cash flow section. Okay, let's get started. So, the first thing we need to calculate a depreciation schedule is always the CAPEX plan, which is the plan that shows any asset purchases that we have coming over the next year or whatever our budgeting period is. So let's say we've been working with our teams and we know that we need to buy a piece of machinery that's worth $250,000 in August of 2024. So we would put that in there, and remember, any hard-coded inputs in Excel when you're building a financial model, hard-coded means just typed in, no formula, put it in dark blue. It's a rule of thumb for financial formatting, and so make sure that you do that so that you can other people can read your models. Okay, so $250,000, and we've been working with our engineering team. They need a piece of software that's going to cost $160,000. So over the next 12 months, we're going to spend $410,000 on asset purchases. So let's now calculate the depreciation associated with these asset purchases. So let's say the machinery has a useful life of 12 months and the software has a useful life of 36 months. Here's a really easy way to calculate the depreciation schedule. So I would just take the $250,000, tap F4, which locks the row and the column, and divide it by the useful life. And then I would tap F4 again, lock the row and the column, and hit enter. Then Control C, Shift right arrow, Control V. That's just copy-paste. So you can see that for the last 5 months of the year, we'll be depreciating this asset, and if we were gonna extend this forecast into the next year, we would show the full 12 months of the depreciation of the asset. Software is exactly the same. Hit equals, grab the CapEx total, lock the row and the column, and divide it by 36, and tap F4 again. So we would, again, extend this the full 36-month lifetime of the asset were we to build a 3 or 4 year forecast right now. But for these next 12 months, this is what we can expect from these assets. And so this shows you your total new depreciation, but don't forget, you will always have historical depreciation that's rolling forward from past asset purchases. So the easiest way to get this is to ask your accounting team. They will know that you bought, say, a piece of software 2 years ago, and the depreciation of that software might be 3 years. They'll have the exact dates, and they'll have the exact amount of depreciation that they're planning to book. So you can get this straight from them. In the case that they didn't have the information, you could go through the asset schedule yourself and look at, you know, when did you purchase the asset, what's the useful life. But you need to get this information and add it to the new depreciation to get your real total depreciation. So this total depreciation line is the depreciation schedule. So now we've calculated this. By the way, you can download this Excel template in the description below for free and use it for yourself. And if you like this content, please like this video and subscribe to my channel right now. It would really help me out, and I'll keep making content like this. Okay, so now you have total depreciation, but what do you do with it? Well, you need to link it back into the three financial statements, and I'm going to show you how to do that right here. So you have the balance sheet, the income statement, and the cash flow statement. So let's say on the balance sheet, you have your net fixed assets section, and this is where the depreciation lives. And we have $750,000 of assets on the balance sheet. And then we have $425,000 of accumulated depreciation. If you add these together, you get the net fixed asset value, which is the assets minus their accumulated depreciation. So to forecast the asset value going forward, you'll just take the historical assets and you add the CapEx to them. And so you'll see, and I hit Control C, Shift right arrow, Control V, this will show that the value of the assets is increasing over time, which makes sense because we're purchasing assets, and so the value of the assets on our balance sheet should be going up. But to tie the depreciation back in, you need to take your depreciation, which is always showed as a negative number, and actually subtract your monthly depreciation. So this will show how you accumulate depreciation over time and how that offsets the value of your assets. And this is really important because this will then show you your net fixed asset value over time, and you can just feed that straight onto the balance sheet, and then you're done. Okay, so the net fixed asset value is about $500,000 at the end of the year. But what about the income statement? The income statement is easy. You just tie the depreciation straight in to the income statement, and you link it in, and it's usually linked into the operating expenses, but sometimes it's in the cost of sales if it's related to the direct production of the product. But in general, you just link it straight in. It's not a negative number or anything. You just put it in as an expense, and it flows through, and that helps you to calculate correctly your operating expenses and your net income so that you're showing the cost of the asset spread over the useful lifetime of the asset. And on the cash flow statement, you link it in identically to the income statement, but the purpose is actually different. So this is going to be in the first section of your cash flow statement, which is the cash flows from operations. And the purpose of this section is to start with net income and make a bunch of adjustments to net income to try to figure out what was your actual operating cash flow. So the reason you link depreciation in this is because depreciation is actually a non-cash expense. It's showing up on the income statement as $15,000, but it's not like $15,000 of cash went out the door. So you need to add this back to net income to try to figure out what is your actual cash change in terms of the balance sheet. So you link it in identically, but it represents something different, and it helps you figure out a different metric, which is your operating cash flow. So these are the three ways that you link the depreciation into your financial statements. Again, if you want to download this file and use it, feel free to download it in the description below for free. I also linked to my lesson on how to build a full three-statement financial model from scratch. I highly recommend that you check that out if you don't know how to do that. Also, if you found this content valuable, please subscribe and click the little bell icon so you don't miss any of my new videos. Hit the like button and also leave me a comment below. And finally, check out my online courses if you need to improve your Excel and finance skills. Okay, that's all for today. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.